In this video, we go hands-on with the Aikido Note Lite with Intel Optane 905P SSD, a super-fast Thunderbolt 3-enabled solid-state drive. Let's have a look. How's it going, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls? This is Jeff Benjamin with 9to5 Mac. Here it is, the Intel Optane SSD, accompanied by the Aikido Note Lite. This is a special edition of the Aikido Note Lite. You have your documentation inside, of course, the device itself, power brick and power cable, and some additional accessories like cable ties, the Thunderbolt 3 cables, some screws. So here is the Aikido Note Lite, the special edition in Fire Engine Red with that acrylic window that is completely see-through. So you can see that SSD inside once we mount it. So it has dual Thunderbolt 3 ports and a DisplayPort connection as well. So you can daisy chain, connect to 4K, display, whatever the case may be. Those thumb screws allow for easy access. And here's what the inside of the Aikido Note Lite looks like up close and personal. You see that PCIe slot, and you can see the fan and fan connector, LED connector for the front LED, and also a couple of thumb screws for securing any PCIe cards you wish to use. Obviously, we're using the Optane SSD. This is a 960 gigabyte SSD, so nearly a terabyte of storage, up to 2600 megabytes per second read. So very, very fast drive, in other words. So here it is. Let's take it out of the package. And there we go, the Intel Optane SSD 905P, up close and personal. This thing will run you about $1,300 by itself. And if you look closely, you can see that thermal material between the board and the heatsink. And that keeps it passively cooled. But of course, the Note Lite enclosure does include a fan, a very loud fan, I might mention. No surprise, the regular edition of the Aikido Note Lite also had a very loud fan. I recommend replacing that if at all possible. So here it is, folks, the Intel Optane SSD 905P inside the Aikido Note Lite enclosure. So we're ready to go ahead and put the cover back on, just like this, and then lock it down with the thumb screws. Now, when you have this thing connected, one thing you're going to notice is that the Intel Optane SSD has LEDs. And as you can see, they're blue and they're very bright. Now, unfortunately, Mac users don't have a way of managing the LEDs on the Optane, whereas Windows users have access to a special utility that allows you to manage the LED color and to disable the LEDs outright. So something to keep in mind for sure. Hopefully, Intel does release a way for Mac users to manage those LEDs. Okay, enough complaining about lights. Let's talk about what really matters here, and that, of course, is speed. And this combination, the Aikido Note Lite with the Intel Optane 905P SSD, as you can see, has the speed and delivers on its claims. This thing is fast, and not just fast for a period of time, but it's fast throughout the entire transfer. So if you're transferring only just a few files, or you're transferring one large file or a bunch of large files, this thing stays consistently fast. As you can see there, the read speeds and the write speeds stay consistently fast. Here's what we have for our Blackmagic, our Aja, and our QuickBench testing. You can see read speeds a little bit faster. They come close to that 2600 megabytes per second. Write speeds aren't that far behind either, but here's what's really impressive. Notice the TPS column on the IOSTAT. This thing can move a lot of data every single second, and it doesn't throttle down. There's no thermal throttling that I noticed at all. So that means that the file transfers are just as fast at the end of the transfer as they were when they first started. And this can be a big deal depending on your particular workflow. Needless to say, I'm impressed. SSDs can get ridiculously hot. This is a passively cooled SSD. Yes, I know the Aikido Note has its little fan, but even with that fan unplugged, yes, I unplugged it because the noise was driving me nuts. Even with it unplugged, I noticed no thermal throttling with the Optane SSD. And that's impressive because it delivers some of the best consistent performance in both read and write that I've tested. If you appreciate this video, please leave me a thumbs up, subscribe for more videos like this, and let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. This is Jeff with 9to5 Mac.